a better name to call you. Make her of universe. Make her of universe. I do not know how to explain. You unexplainable. You unexplainable. I do not know a better name to call you. Make her of universe. Make her of universe. Unexplainable, you unexplainable. You're bigger than all my thoughts. You're bigger than my mind. You're greater than the greatest. Oh God, you made the world to be. Creator of existence, all the glory is yours. Yahweh, you are the greatest. You are the greatest. For you are the greatest. You are the greatest. Yeah.
I do not know a better name to call. Make her of universe. Make her of universe. I do not know how to explain. You unexplainable. You unexplainable. I do not know a better name.
Yeah, a blessing. Good morning. What a great day to be alive. I want to bless God this morning and thank Him for His goodness. Yeah, I do not know a better name to call you. Yes, sir. Yeah, bigger than my mind, greater than the greatest. Oh God. You made the world to be, creator of existence, and all the glory is yours. What a pleasant day to be alive. We want to say good morning to all of you, and we appreciate you in a special way. Thank you for the honor of being in your homes this morning, and that we all can work up together in God's presence, seeking Him. David said in Psalm 63, O God, you are my God. Early would I seek Thee, my soul longed for Thee, my heart trusted Thee, in the bright and thirsty land where there is no water. To see the power and the glory as I've seen it in the sanctuary. This morning is great to be alive. I want to thank God for all of you. Thank God for our own wonderful artist, Paul K. Harden, ministering to us. Greatest. Our God is the greatest. There's not even anybody. He cannot be compared to anything or anyone. He says, supreme in all that He does. And so we give Him the glory this morning and welcome all of you online. We pray that you continue to be an ambassador of this broadcast, sharing the broadcast with as many persons as possible. In this time, we're discussing our season of recovery, and in that, we are discussing a lot of issues surrounding recovery. How do you recover? What are the process that leads to it? And so of that. And so this morning, we are grateful to you. We pray that indeed you make yourself available. Jesus said, come and learn of me so you have rest for your souls. We pray that indeed, as you go through these teachings, you really have rest in your spirit, and the Lord will bring you to a place of stability where you can be a beacon of hope to as many persons as possible, and you can relax yourself and see the glory of God be revealed in your life in a mighty way. So, I want to thank God for all of you, and we appreciate God for you being there. Thank you for sharing. We're going to give you some time. I'll leave the next 1 or 2 minutes. Reach out and share and invite someone. So that we move ahead in prayer this morning. Yeah. Yes, you are the greatest.
You
are the greatest.
Oh, thank you, thank
you. You are the greatest. Yeah.
Unexplainable.
You are unexplainable.
To make all,
yeah. You are maker of the universe.
The indescribable.
Indescribable. Someone help me worship the Lord this morning. Lift your hands, lift your heart, lift your spirit. Wherever you are, let's worship the great God. He's the greatest. He's the greatest. He's the greatest. He's the greatest. That's it. Someone help me worship him.
You are, you are, you are. I know you are.
You are. You are the
greatest.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, you are the greatest. Glory, blessed. We shall be going to prayers. We shall be going to prayers. Ah, yes. Yeah, yeah.
I know it
is. Yes, we should be going to prayers. A privilege to call you, Abba Father.
Abba Father.
Yeah.
Abba Father.
That's it. Yes, sir. Because you are the greatest, my tomorrow shall be better than today. Yeah. Thank you. Somebody help me.
Nothing
can I reach to you. Oh, that's a song of this season. It's prophetic.
See your tears. It's here and I know that they cannot hear your prayer. Your tomorrow must be greater than today. Your tomorrow must be greater than today.
No matter what I say, no matter how I cry,
one thing I know, that is definite.
Tomorrow must be greater than today.
My tomorrow must be greater than today. No matter what I see,
yeah,
what comes my way, no matter how I cry, one thing I know,
that is definite,
my tomorrow must be greater than today, yeah, yeah, my tomorrow. I'm gonna sing in my tomorrow.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah. I'm gonna dance in my tomorrow.
Defining my tumor. One thing I know, that is definitely in my heart. Oh yes, I can promise say my tomorrow shall be better than today. Oh yeah, that's when I wake up this morning with grace, with favor, with strength, with vigor this morning. This morning I'm celebrating the Lord because God has been good, God has been faithful, God has been sustaining, God has been protecting, God has just been everything to me. Oh yeah. I will testify in my tomorrow. One thing I know, that is definite in my heart. My tomorrow shall be greater than today. And I want to let you know that your tomorrow shall be greater than today. That's why you can allow yourself to cry. Wipe away your tears. Don't be mournful. Rise up in the spirit of grace this morning and take hold of your destiny and move forward. Oh yeah. You're gonna dance into your tomorrow. By your tomorrow. I said that is definitely in my heart. This morning I want to take up time to appreciate our regular followers, the viewers this morning. A lot of you who follow us regularly will say we acknowledge you this morning and thank you, especially servants of God and generals in the army of Christ that I continue to see you follow us. We want to thank you this morning for following us and being a part of this time. We thank you so much. We appreciate you for that. We thank you for sons and daughters here in Liberia, in the U.S. I'm going to get in trouble this morning and start calling names because I'm seeing the names rolling up. Hallelujah. But let me get a bit of trouble this morning. You know, we thank God. Some of our regular fellows, even I don't remember if I'm just going to call it this morning. This is still from the U.S. Those of you who call follow regular, Brother Patrick, Namu Williams, Sister Magdalene Gashua, Sister Comfort Davis, Sister Eming Bucci, this morning. Yeah, yeah, can I get into it? Doris Howard this morning. Yep, 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 yep. Just call me best. Hallelujah, Rich Morris. Hallelujah, following us. Yeah, this morning. We thank God for all of you, this merciless looker. The list goes on. Reverend Colley, you get in trouble this morning. Yeah, fly across the U.S. And then we have a good one, Brother Chester Weir, Brother Luscious, that we are also, he's also one of the followers. Oh yeah, my tomorrow must be greater than today. We keep calling, Sister Cooper Kennedy, yeah. Sister Colu Kesseli. Hallelujah today. Sister Stephanie Gama, Biba Gama. Sister Esther Cosa. Amen today. I can see up in heaven. Pouring down blessings. Blessings are pouring unto you this morning, wherever you are. In your home, in your family, in your business, in your life, in your health, whatever it is. That's it.
I can see.
Yeah, Jolie Joy. Yeah, 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 yeah. Tomorrow. Yeah. Oh yes, we're about to hit prayer. You know, this morning there's a time of celebration, and we're giving another tip this morning. We're going to go to a short time of prayer, and then we'll move to the word. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yes, sir. Speak, 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 speak. This time we get to our own. We thank God for all of you. This morning, the story of the man following us.
Lord, I'm calling you right now for
I yeah.
You
to Scott.
Thank you, Jesus. Yeah.
Sorry, my brothers. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
Yeah. Bear. Hello, Maria. This morning. We thank you this morning. Hey, all of you, if I don't call you, don't get in trouble. I just decided to let you know that we're checking on all of you who are following us. Yeah, I want to go general. I salute you this morning.
It was a ceremony just before the break of day. Jesus entered into my room and he touched me. I felt a touch of me. I felt the presence of the Lord. He washed my sins away. He washed my sins away. I started running, rolling as jubilating. There's no more doubting in my life, no more doubting. Oh, I believe your blood speaks on. Let your presence, nothing but your presence. My soul reaches out to you, and I'm available. What you say you would do. My will I give to you to do what you say.
To show someone
one way, never be to say, hey, yeah, yeah. Speak love, speak love, speak love. Let your blood speak love, speak love. Speak love, let your blood speak love, speak love, speak love, speak love, let your blood speak love, speak love, speak love, speak love. Let your blood speak, Lord.
Oh, this morning. Speak this morning. Speak, Lord, this morning. Speak into our lives. Speak into our families. Speak over our community. Speak over our nation. Speak into the various sectors of our society this morning. Let the blood speak this morning. Let the blood speak in our eyes. Let the blood speak strength. Let the blood speak in new world.
Plans of good health, plans of good health, not plans of evil. But to bring to us unexpected end,
to destroy us and destroy our lives. But you, Lord, you came. You came to give us life more abundantly. I more abundantly. Your blood speak this morning, Lord. Let the blood speak this morning. Let it speak. Let it speak for every home. Let it speak to everyone viewing and paying attention. Let it speak deliverance. Let it speak holiness. Let it speak liberty. Let it speak transformation. Let the blood speak. Let the blood speak. To the highest mountain and flows to the lowest valley. Your blood has power to give us life this morning, Lord. Whatever is dying, let it come to life. Whatever is not working, let it work. Whatever is not on course, let it get on course. In the name of Jesus, we overturn and overthrow everything working contrary to the purpose of God. Yeah. Let the blood speak this morning. Let the blood speak this morning, Lord. Let your blood speak. Let's speak righteousness this morning, God. That's what we desire. That's what we want. That's what we want to experience. Yeah. Speak, Lord God, this morning. Yes, sir, Lord. Let the blood speak. Father, we want to thank you this morning. I want to give you praise and glory. Thank you for speaking this morning. Thank you for speaking to us. Thank you, God, for touching us. Thank you for ministering to our heart. Thank you for ministering to our spirit. Thank you for ministering to our soul, for bringing change and transformation. Thank you for bringing home a healing. Thank you for being there, oh God. We praise you this morning. Lord, we don't have words enough this morning. Our hearts are filled with your goodness and your love. The dimensions which you bless us and visit us as continue to work in our lives. We don't know what to say this morning, God. We just come to say we love you and appreciate you. We give you praise and glory and honor. We magnify you for being good, for being loving, for being faithful, Lord. We present this day to you this morning. We ask, Lord, renew our strength. Restore our joy this morning. Let your glory be revealed this morning. Father, this morning, by the blood of Jesus, we come against every setup. We come against every conspiracy. We come against every projection. We come against every manipulation. We come against everything not of God. Whatever is raised and hidden in secret places, we overturn, we destroy, we dismantle, we scatter the fire this morning. It is written, whatever our Father has not planted shall be uprooted. You said the others shall gather. You said it will not be by you. You said anyone that will rise up against us. We're poor for our sin. You said no weapon that is formed against us shall prosper. And every tongue that rises shall be condemned in judgment. We prosper the works of darkness. We destroy the plagues of darkness. We overturn the works of evil.
We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your unction.
In the name of Jesus, we pray this morning, God. Whatever the enemy of orchestrated in hidden places against your people, their lives, their destiny, as they face a new day this morning, we pray it shall not stand, it shall not work, it shall not come to pass. We overturn by the blood, we scatter by fire, we destroy in the name of Jesus.
by the blood of Jesus. We'll overturn the works of darkness. We'll nullify their plans. We'll nullify their setup. We'll say their counsel shall not stand. Their counsel shall not come to pass. Their counsel shall not prevail. In the name of Jesus Christ. When you said, if we shall ask anything in your name, it shall be given us. And this day we stand upon the authority of the blood. We neutralize and nullify every projection in the realm of our life, realm of our community, realm of the nation. We neutralize the workings of the evil one. We overturn their setup, their conspiracies, their operations, their projections, their spells. In the name of Jesus Christ, we release the blood, we release the fire, we release the anointing. We pray this day that whatever our Father has not planted shall be uprooted, shall be uprooted, shall be uprooted. Let the fire of God consume. Let the fire of God overthrow. Let the fire of God nullify. Let the fire of God dismantle. Let the fire of God crush. Put them to shame, Lord. Give us a new day. Give us a new day.
Give me a new day.
Give us a new day.
Give me a new day.
Give us a new day, Lord.
I don't want yesterday.
We don't want yesterday. We want a new day.
All I want is a new day.
We want a new day, Lord. A new day in our lives. A new day in our families. A new day. A new day.
Yesterday brought the peace
and
frustration.
A new day. A new day.
I don't want yesterday.
No, we don't want yesterday. We want a new day. Give us a new day. Give us a new day, Lord. Thank you this morning. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Oh, Mashika.
Put
them to shame. Let it not be good. Show up. Show yourself mighty. Reveal yourself. Reveal your glory.
I am a sinner. I'm committed to have mercy on me, God. I've come to you, Yahweh.
Give me a new day.
A new day. Give me a new day.
Thank you, Father.
Give me a new day.
Yes, a new day, Lord. A new day. A new day.
I don't want yesterday.
Oh, a new day. A new day.
Oh, that I want.
A new day. A new day.
I want a new day, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
I want a new day, Lord. I want a new day in marriage, Lord.
A new day.
I want a new day in my business, Lord. I want a new day in my ministry. I want a new day
God,
for
I thank you for the restoration.
I want a new day for
the help of that brother
and sister.
Watch it. Restore it completely. Everyone with a complication. Everyone with a complication. Visit and change the story. Visit and change the story. Everyone with a complication. Everyone with a complication. Visit and change the story. Visit and do something new. Do something different. Do something mighty. Do something awesome in the midst of your people. Lord. Thank you this morning. Thank you, Jesus.
And the parents have been crying for years.
A new day.
For that child, for that man, for that woman that have been sick for years. And the doctors have given up. Oh, my hero.
Yes, indeed, I want a new day. Give me a new day.
Lord, you
should be better than the word.
You should forgive,
yeah, the yes. Yeah, yeah.
You said, behold,
we're
about to do a new
thing. Yes, sir, we believe in Lord this morning.
You said you would do something new in my life.
Do something new in my life.
Oh, now there's something that's here with my voice.
Remarkable. Oh, I am in the shame, Lord.
Yesterday, what I want is a new day. Yesterday broke my heart. Yesterday brought me peace and frustration. I don't want yesterday. What I want is a new day. Yesterday, my loved one left me. Yesterday, my marriage was broken. I don't want yesterday. What I want. bless a new day. Yesterday, my hopes and dreams, all my plans for the future, they were all shackled. Lord, I want a new day. Everything that brought me joy, everything that brought me laughter, they have been stolen from me. Lord, I want a new day. I want a new day in my business. I want a new day in my career. I want a new day. Please give me a new day. 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 Please give me a new day. Yesterday I had to struggle before I survived. Yesterday I had to hustle before I can make it. I don't want yesterday. What I want is a new day. Everybody laughing at me. They're asking where's the God serving. That's what I've come to you, Lord Jesus. What I want is a new day. You are the only God I know. You are the only God that I'm serving. You said that I put that trust in you, Lord. That shall never be put to shame. I've come to you with my pains. I've come to you with my troubles. Oh, my hero, what I want is a new day. Lord, you said in your word, I should forget, yeah, the former things. You said, behold, you are about to do a new thing. You said you would do something new in my life. All the eyes of them that see it will marvel. Put my enemies to shame, Lord. Please give me a new day. Give me a new day. Give me a new day. I don't want yesterday.
A new day.
Yesterday broke my heart.
Yesterday broke
me peace and frustration. I don't want yesterday. All I want.
It's a new day. Yeah. It's a new day.
Give me 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 a new day.
What's my enemies are shame.
Thank you, Father, for doing this.
Just give me a new day.
Thank you, Jesus.
Give me a new day, God.
We bless you, Father.
We trust you for the word.
Speak to us by your spirit this morning. Touch us by your anointing. Do something new.
Please give me a new day.
We want a new day. Thank you, Father.
Give me a new day. Give me a new day.
Yeah.
I don't want yesterday.
I don't want yesterday. Yeah, I want to bless God this morning. This morning we are continuing from our message on yesterday's morning, which is our series, My Season of Recovery. And I'd like you to say to yourself, my season of recovery. This is my season of recovery. We started sharing in our last, to have recovery, we must shift our spiritual capacity. I And we say for us to shift our spiritual capacity. There are things that needs to be in place. One of them is that we need to understand the reality of the supernatural, both the negative and the positive. We said there was a negative and there was a positive, the supernatural. That is our yesterday morning morning message. Then the second thing we talk about, we say you got to know the authority given you that makes you a destined overcomer. You got to know the authority. So after you get to understand the reality of the supernatural, you got to know the authority given you. Because if you don't know the authority given you and where it comes from and who backs you, that will also hinder how you approach the issues of life. You now want to approach the issue of life on the place of advantage or on the place of confidence, but you're going to be in fear and you're going to not be able to rest and trust in God and know that God has the ability to change it. This morning, I want to move further. I want to talk about knowing the weapons available to you that puts you in an advantageous position. Knowing the weapons available to you that puts you in an advantageous position is what I want to talk about this morning. Knowing the weapons available to you that puts you in our advantageous position. As a child of God and as a person walking with the Lord, you must understand that as you walk with the Lord, there are weapons, there are things the Bible have entrusted to you. Apart from the authority given, yesterday we talked about the authority, and the authority comes to put the Bible say, Jesus, when he died, he raised us up to sit with him in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. And it's from that place of authority that we project from and we operate from. And so from that realm of operation, we come to the place of understanding that indeed we have the authority and we have weapons available to us. And you got to know these weapons, because if you don't know these weapons, what will happen is that you will not be able to properly apply and use those things that are made available, and you become a victim though everything is available to you. And so God's desire for us is that we take measures and we walk in such a way that at the end of the day our lives will be well protected. And when we take action and when we speak and when we make declarations and when we stand, the kingdom is going to back us, because the weapons we are using eventually will win. In the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 10 beginning at verse 4, I'd like us to read it. Second Corinthians 10 beginning of verse 4. Everything that brought me joy, everything that brought me love to, it says, for the weapons, begin of verse 3 anyway, say, for though we walk in the flesh, we are not carrying on a warfare according to the flesh and using many most weapons. For the weapons of our warfare are not physical weapons of flesh and blood, but they are mighty before God for the overthrow and the destruction of strongholds. Inasmuch as we refute arguments, theories, and reasons, and every proud and lofty thing that sets itself up against the true knowledge of God, and we lead every thought and purpose away captive into the obedience of Christ, the Messiah, the Anointed One. So yeah, the scripture is telling us that as God's children and as servants of God, we are involved in a battle. There's a battle for stability, a battle for fulfillment, a battle to remain relevant, a battle for elevation. Everything that you ever look forward to attaining to in your life as a person, as an individual, as a believer, what is going to happen is that from day to day, you are going to be involved in a battle. And the intent of that battle is to make sure you don't obtain and you don't maintain what God has made available to you as his child and as his servant. And so this battle is a spiritual warfare. And so the Bible tells us in 2 Corinthians 10 4 that though we live in the flesh, but the warfare we are involving is not a human fleshly warfare. It's by saying instead the weapons of our warfare, the weapons that are made available to us, that gives us the capacity and that strengthens us to achieve this work, they are not counter. They are not regular human, human kind of a weapon like the AK, the bazooka, the AUSA 106, the 40 barrel, and the name the list goes on, all this kind of M16, you know, M60, the G3, and you can go and name all the different guns as they are. But you must be able to understand that they are weapons, they are not counter, they are mighty to God. And the Bible says they have the ability to pull down strongholds. And that's why sometimes I love, you know, when I see situation, people are acting like they are strongholds. Because the weapons we fight with, are not talking weapons. We don't talk much. In fact, real servants of God who know what is not talk much. And sometimes when people hear you not talking as a believer and not involving physical, you know, something, they think that it is weakness. In fact, when a believer really knows the Lord and doesn't talk much and is quiet about issue, you need to be careful with that person, because those are the people, the modern day, that can shift the events and change the course of time. And so the Bible says the weapons we fight with are not carnal. They are not carnal. It said, but they are mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. That means that no matter how high certain things are, no matter where things sit, that it has the ability to bring it down. Now, right now, you may be ministering, you may be listening to me, and there are challenges you are facing in your personal life, your family, community, even as a nation, a different thing. And when you look at most of the issues, they appear like they are so difficult, you know. And, you know, somebody you're talking to, minister of the gospel, you hear, you know, talking things, and you think that it is so difficult. And you know that indeed, as a servant of God, that there are things God can handle. And before you make up mind, they are history. You know, we've seen a lot of things become history before God. In my short life, I've seen a lot of things become history. And that's why sometimes when I see people misbehaving, crossing the path, crossing the line, sometimes what I do to myself as a minister is to keep my heart right. Because many people don't know that there's a place you can provoke a servant of God, and when they project certain things, even if they don't really mean it, God takes it serious and God addresses that particular issue. And so when you want God to use you to kind of be a blessing to people, to make sure that people purpose, that God's plan for people are fulfilled, you want to keep a right heart and don't allow people attitude to provoke you to get to, you know, to shift. Because as a servant of God, when you are provoked and you shift, just as you shift, especially when it's justifiable, when the kingdom see it as, you know, certain things are going out of order, the kingdom get into action. And at that point, if you are not careful, you know, there can be casualties. I've seen it happen over and over. There can be several casualties, you know. And so I want you to understand as a child of God that there are weapons. And the battle we fight are not physical battles. The Bible says they are mighty to the pulling down of strongholds. The Bible says it has the power to cast down imagination. That means the kind of weapon we use can go into people's mind and deal with issues in their mind. It casts down imagination. And it says it casts down every high thing, no matter how high it is. And it brings it to the obedience of Christ. So you need to understand that these are clear, established truth in God's word. And so the weapons we fight with as believers are not physical weapons. They are not carnal. They are not natural things. But the Bible says they are mighty. And much that they are not carnal. They are not things you can hold to, you can touch, you can feel. They are mighty. You know, some of them are words, certain declarations, certain things you do. You know, and sometimes when you do it, it looks ordinary. But eventually, the impact at the end of the day, the result at the end of the day, brings mighty transformation and brings an awesome change to a given environment. And so I want you to know today that as a person and as a child of God, the weapons of God are available to you. The grace of God is available to you that can make you achieve anything you want to achieve, that can make you accomplish whatever you want to accomplish, that can make you make the difference in a given period. And I believe in this time and season we find ourselves, God's grace and power, insight and wisdom has been released to you that will make you stand out, that will make you bring a change and a revolution in your given environment. I believe at this time and season, there are things that are going to shift. Even some difficult things people were thinking are impossible. I believe in the next few days, weeks, indeed, there's going to be a shift in the realm of the spirit. There's going to be a shifting
a mighty ship that will bring certain things to order, to the glory of God. And so we need to understand that God is not like us, you know. He's not like man. You know, and people who don't understand these things, most time, you know, you feel sorry for them. You feel sorry for them. My prayer for you is that you walk in the fear of God. You know, fear of God. Don't act like you know God. Fear God. God is not in your class. He's not your equal. You know, I feel sorry for people who try to make fun of God and make chest of teeth of God. What they do is that they set themselves up for a blast. They set themselves up. It's like drinking poison, you know, committing suicide. You know what it means? To take God for granted, you must be out of your mind. Something must be wrong with you. You can carry your bluff and your joke every side. The last place you want to bring that is towards God. Because what it does to you is that it naked you, it exposes you, it makes you vulnerable, and it brings you to a place where the enemy can just rubbish you. You know? My prayer for you is that you will reverently. So I know, yes, you got phone, you do things, but when you're doing your foolishness, don't bring it close to God. Keep it in the realm. Do it with human beings. And anything that is attached to God, don't bring it in that realm. Because you may provoke something that you may not be able to settle, you know. But I pray the mercy of God for you today. That in any way you have stepped out of course and you have missed some events of life and allowed deception and wrong copying and different things to affect you, that the Spirit of God will help you today, and there will be a restoration and recovery in your life to the glory of God in Jesus' name. But you understand some of these things. So you got to know the weapons available to you that puts you in an advantageous position. Now, God has given us weapons. Now, one of the weapons we have is the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus is a weapon in the life of a believer, in the life of a child, but the name of Jesus. In Philippians 2, 5 to 12, it says something. Philippians 2, 5 to 12. It says here, let the same attitude and purpose, humble, might be in you which was in Christ, who though being essentially one with God, and in the form of God, possessing the fullness of the attributes which make God God, did not think this equality with God was a thing to be eagerly grasped or retained, but strip himself of all privileges and rightful dignity so as to assume the guise of a servant, slave, in that he became like man and was born a human being. And after he had appeared in human form, he abased and humbled himself and carried his obedience to the extreme of death, even the death of the cross. Therefore, because he stooped so low, God has highly exalted him and I freely bestow on him the name that is above every name. That at the name of Jesus, every knee should must in heaven and on earth. Must bow in heaven and on and earth, and under the earth. And every tongue, frankly, openly, confess and acknowledge that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father Almighty. So, one of the weapons that is made available to us God's children as a servant is the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus is not a toy. It has an energy in it. No. It's a weapon. It's a weapon. And so when you pray and you pray in the name of Jesus, there's so much power and authority that goes with it. That name alone has the ability to bring everything to its knees. Because the Bible says at the mention of his knee, every knee shall bow in heaven, on earth, and beneath the earth, and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father Almighty. And so I want you to understand that it is an established truth and an established reality that at the mention of the name of Jesus, every knee bows. Every knee is supposed to bow. Every knee, tongue is supposed to confess to the glory of God the Father Almighty. It's an established issue. And so when you as a child of God say in the name of Jesus, either you pray or you bind or whatever, you say in the name of Jesus, you need to understand that that name is a weapon. That name has the ability to neutralize
to empower, to enforce, to establish things. So when you use it, you must use it with confidence. You must use it with assurance. You must use it knowing that it's like what makes a military man bold enough to see the enemy and move towards the enemy. Because in his hands he has this G3, and he knows that when he opens fire, it has the ability to cause casualty. It has the ability to penetrate. It has the ability. If a man is using an anti-war tank, or he's using an armor vehicle, or he's using a bazooka, or a caliber 50 or caliber 30, whatever it is he's using, what makes him bold to move towards the enemy? Because he knows the capacity of that weapon. As children of God, we need to understand the capacity of the weapon that we possess, the weapon that we carry. When we submit our life to Christ, when we come into connection with Christ, there are weapons made available to us that we have the ability to use, and we have the right to use. And as we use it, it produces a particular result. It produces a particular fruit. It effects a particular change. It compels obedience. And that's why I believe that some obedience are going to be compelled. Not too long for now. There will be some compelled obedience. Not noise. Compelled obedience. God will show up and put some things in place in your life. And put something in place in your family. And put something in place in your community. And put some things in place in this nation. God will put some things in place. Because when people don't know their line, don't know where to stop, and don't know where to stop their foolishness, automatically, God has a way of teaching them a lesson. So there are some things that are misbehaving in your family and in your life. Listen to me. They will be taught a lesson by the weapon of God that is available to you. Listen. The Bible says it's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of an angry God. It's a fearful thing. You don't want to see. You don't want to walk that path. You don't want to walk. And I encourage you as a child of God. The Bible says as much as is possible, do your best to find out what the will of the Lord is. What the will of the Lord is. Yeah. Yes. Find out what the will of the Lord is. Yes. Yeah. Speak, Lord. Speak, Lord. Yeah. Oh. Yeah. We bless him. We thank him. We praise him today. So that's the name of Jesus. The second weapon God has given us is the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus is a weapon. It's a weapon. It's a weapon. The blood of Jesus is a weapon. The blood of Jesus can neutralize. The blood of Jesus can enforce. The blood of Jesus can dismantle. The blood of Jesus can crush. The blood of Jesus can heal and can afflict. The blood of Jesus can assemble and disassemble. The blood of Jesus is a weapon in the hand of the believer. And today I pray that by the blood of Jesus, that there will be a mighty restoration in your life. By the blood of Jesus, everything gang up against your life, everything rising up against the purpose of God in your life, I see them being defeated. I see them being crushed. I see them being subdued. I see them being nullified. I see them being overturned. I see them coming to the place of being completely subdued and brought to naught in the name of Jesus Christ. If you believe it, say amen with me. Yes, say amen with me. Yeah. Thank you, Lord. Yes. The name of Jesus, the blood of Jesus. These are two powerful weapons that can put sense into the enemy's head. And I see the blood of Jesus putting sense into the enemy's on your behalf. I see the blood of Jesus neutralizing the power of evil over your life. I see the blood of Jesus being a judgment against the powers of darkness and forces of evil. I see the name of Jesus subduing, bringing to naught everything that is exalting itself to a place it don't belong. I bring it into subjection by the blood of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, this morning I take authority over every power, over your life, over your family, over the community, over this nation. Power forces that want to stand in the purpose and the plan of God, I bring you to subjection. I compel forceful obedience to the will of God. In the name of Jesus Christ, I decree that by the anointing. And in the name of Jesus Christ, and by the blood of Jesus, I seal in the realm. And I decree in the name of Jesus that no power, no foes, no individuals that stands in the purpose of God shall have stability. I decree that in the name of Jesus Christ. I decree you restless. I decree you unstable. I decree you vulnerable and exposed in the name of Jesus Christ. Until you submit to the will of God by the blood of Jesus Christ. I thank you, Father, and I honor you. In Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. And amen. And amen. And amen. And amen. Declare this morning every voice that attempts to mock God, I decrease as I stand on this altar. Any attempt to mock God in this season, the hand of God is stretched out against you, and you shall not survive it. In Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. And amen. And amen. Not against your family. Not against the purpose of God. Not against God's name. Every mocker will bring you into subjection. The Bible says in 1 Samuel 2 verse 10, it says, they that honor me, I will honor me. And those that despise me, I will lightly esteem them. I decree today, you that decide to despise God and despise the purposes of God, I decree, may you be lightly esteemed beginning this day in the name of Jesus. No matter where you are, as you attempt it, you go down and never rise again in Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. We decree that by the blood of the Lamb. Go down in that family. You go down in that community. You go down in this nation. In the name of Jesus Christ. Because God that exalts and his seat that pulls down. Thank you, Father. We establish over the realms of our nation by the blood of the Lamb. In Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. And amen. And amen. And amen. This morning, we decree restoration in your life. Restoration in our family. Restoration in our community. Restoration in our nation. In our nation. That everything that is getting out of order, that is getting out of place, we command into place. We command into stability. We command into obedience. In the name of Jesus, we decree it over the realms of this nation. Thank you, Father, for doing so. We honor you. We bless you. We exalt you. We bless you. Let your blood speak. 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 We plead your blood. Let your blood speak. Let your blood speak. Let your blood speak. Let your blood speak. Let your blood speak.
Speak in the touch, Lord. Speak in the ministry. I tell you, Lord, I want to
let the blood speak. Let the blood speak. Let the blood speak. Let the blood speak. I am. Let the blood speak. Thank you. Let the blood speak. Father, blood speaking. Father, blood speaking. Father, blood speaking. Let the blood speak. Let it speak. Let it speak. Let it speak. Let the blood speak. Let the blood speak. Let the blood speak. Let the blood speak. Speak, O God. Thank you this morning. Just speaking.
We honor you. We give you praise. We give you worship. Thank you for speaking. Thank you for speaking. We honor you today. We thank you for doing a new thing. Thank you for showing us a strong. Bless you, our God. Forever you. Take your praise. Thank you, Lord. Give you the praise, Lord. Take all the glory. Let your name be honored. Let your name be adored. Thank you for that. Thank you, settle. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 I want to let you know that the name of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, has spoken. And you'll never be the same again. Something strange and something different has happened. And it's going to happen. To the glory of God. God will be exalted in your life. And in the quarters of the earth. He's not like man. He's not our equal. And anyone who attempts to equal themselves with him will be made to understand that he's not an equal. Well, bless the Lord. This is where we would like to start this morning. I would like you to go through your day being blessed, knowing that God is with you and the weapons of God are available to you, and you will make a difference and bring hope and healing to your word and change the paradigm of things to the glory of God. God bless you. In Jesus' mighty name.
Thank you, Jesus, for answering my prayers. Thank you, Lord.
Yeah.
He touched me.
I felt the presence of the Lord. This is the way we like to close the time of prayer today. We like to seal it. And wherever you are, just know that so shall it be. Just say amen in an agreement. And you can post the comment to that effect. And that will be appreciated. God bless you. Also want to inform you that for the rest of the day today, our watch party will be on, will be showing on some TV, online, our different messages, so you can always go in from time to time and build yourself. Some of our recent messages and loaded messages will be there to build your spirit. Send someone there to build, you know, share it, reach out, and as many questions you can get to, let them be blessed by it. God bless you. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. Church, say amen.
Everybody say
amen. Oh, God has spoken. So let the church this morning say amen. Can you say amen this morning? Hey, 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 hey. Let the church say amen. Let the church
to what his word says.
God has spoken. So let the church.
Make this your response.
Amen.
whatever he said. From the healing of your body to the raising of the dead. No matter how you feel or how your world is reeling, battle on through the day. Cause you're gonna win the fight.
Church,
say,
say,
oh, lift your hands wherever you are, and
let the church,
say,
say, let the church,
say,
amen. Yeah. My God has spoken, so let the church, yeah. God has spoken, and so let the church say, amen. Guys, we would like to close. So thank you for being with us. We've been here, we've been here. Until we meet later today at 10 for the time of refreshing. Today we'll be closing finally. Delivered from the spirit in the house. It's going to be a real time of prayer. We trust in the Lord for the great move of God. And the Lord is going to bless in a mighty way. God bless you. Until we meet again. Yeah. I'll be right back.
What the devil?